Hello, this is a short lecture for English speakers, only English speakers, also for Russian speakers who study English, also for English speakers who study Russian. There may be a confusion between the two, just for a person who speaks only English language, and we are going to discuss it here. Effect versus effect. We will discuss what part of speech is it, and we'll see the examples. In English language, we have the examples with effect as a noun. That movie had a great effect on me, used as a noun with descriptive adjective, great. The changes had an immediate effect, used as a noun. Also with descriptive adjective immediate. Its effect was immediate. Again, we have the noun effect. Then we have as an adjective, effective date. The effective date of a purchase is the date the order is received. So we use it as an adjective in English language. In Russian, we have two different adjectives for that, and also the noun. In Russian language, we have effect был неожиданный. The translation to English is the effect was unexpected. Russian effect is a noun. Now we have the example from classics, from Dostoevsky. Преступление и наказание, the crime and punishment. This is the last third of the 19th century. Тем не менее, речь его произвела чрезвычайный эффект. Nevertheless, his speech impressed somebody greatly. In Russian, we don't say on whom, but I put here somebody. So in Russian we have the expression произвести эффект, which Dostoevsky uses here. Произвела чрезвычайный эффект. His speech in English I translate it as impressed. Impressed. His speech impressed somebody. The next we have adjective number one in Russian we use in the meaning impressive, and the example is очень эффектный. In Russian we say очень эффектный. If you want feminine gender, you will say очень эффектная. For example, женщина, the woman. Very impressive, the translation. Also we have adjective number two, different. We have эффективное производство. Эффективное производство. Эффективное производство, the production with high outcome results. This will be эффективный, will be different adjective. So two adjectives for that. No verbs. No verbs. In English language, now we use the act of changing as the verb. We use effect with A. The example is, sorry, the planes here. I didn't plan that. Didn't plan the planes with from the base, military base here. That movie affected me greatly. Affected. This is past tense verb. As we see, we use affect as a verb in English. That movie affected me greatly. In Russian we would say произвело впечатление. Кино, фильм, произвело впечатление. Affected. Now in Russian the same. If you look in the upper right corner and you see in Russian language green color affect. And in Russian we would see what we see, usually we pronounce that thing. So affect. And we use it as a noun. And it is from Latin origin. So Russian, I put here Russian used as a noun. And the example is, we are in the end of the slide now. Он сделал это в состоянии аффекта. He did that in the condition of extreme worry, excitement, nervousness. I put here a noun, affect in Russian is a noun, and I put also expression, used as expression. Expression goes в состоянии аффекта, in the condition of that effect. This is how we use this word in Russian, when in English we use it as a verb, you see, they are here. Together, grouped together, and all of this English and Russian comes from Latin origin, Latin language, and the Latin origin is affectus, and the meaning is passion, the excitement of your heart, of your soul. Passion, this is affectus from Latin language, and in Russian, affect. Thank you. I hope it was useful for everybody. Sorry for the airplanes from the military base. Goodbye.